Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. How we can measure milliamperes, the low value current, using ampere meter mode in any digital multimeter? In my last live stream, I received question from my viewer that milliampere measurement, what are the safeties when we want to measure current? There are some basic points that are to be considered before measuring current, amount of current, current value, type of current, AC or DC, then polarity of current. If you are using digital multimeter, that time the polarity will not matter, but if you are using analog multimeter, that time polarity is very important. What is the capability of the test and measurement device? These are basic parameters when we are measuring current. When we measure voltage, we use these two test sockets, common voltage, ohms and diode. But when we are measuring current, there are different sockets. Common will remain same for these measurements. At that time, voltage, ohms and diode, we will use this one. But for current, we will use these two test sockets. This is for 10 milliampere and this is maximum 400 milliampere. These are fused. Inside there is fuse because it is working as a shunt. That time we will use this multimeter in series with that circuit. We measure voltage in parallel. These are voltage. 4.068 volt. But when we will measure current, that time we will remove this test lead from here and first we will insert in the highest range, 10 ampere. There is a warning that change lead. Now we are in current mode. Ampere, AC or DC, we will use sub function DC amperes. We will disconnect any one line, either positive or negative. Normally negative was connected at negative, positive was connected at positive, but now I opened the circuit. I selected DC amperes because our circuit is now DC. I will connect this multimeter now in series. One line we will connect at this point from where we removed the connection. That is this point. The second lead we will connect here. Before this, it was connected directly, but now the current will come here into the multimeter, then from multimeter it will go to this point. When we are not sure about the amount of current, that time we will use highest range. This time I am using ampere range. It is 35.035. That means it is now within this range. Now I will shift here into milliampere, milliampere DC. milliampere. So it is a perfect method to measure milliamperes. First we will verify the maximum current within that circuit. Let's suppose if the circuit is providing more current, this battery is draining more current, and we connect in this socket, I am not confident that what is the top limit of the current. If current is more than this limit, its fuse will damage, because in multimeters there is fast blow fuse. Now this is the current flowing in this channel, but if we verify by checking current in high range, we connected here, remove this socket from here, go in DC milliampere, Now we are sure that it is safe. Now we are in ampere mode. Now if I will connect this multimeter while placing this lead here to any voltage point, it will make directly short circuit. If we are in 10 ampere, it will damage the fuse, and in some conditions maybe the circuit within this multimeter will finish. So these are very basic and important safeties to be checked while measuring amperes, milliamperes. Now if you connect this multimeter in opposite direction, now the current is in minus, negative sign. That multimeter is connected in reverse direction. Sometime we connect this multimeter while the battery is discharging, that time we will also see the same indication. That flow of current is now in opposite direction. When we finish this measurement, by all means we must swap this lead to this point. If we leave it like this, and in next measurement if I will connect this multimeter to any point, that time that will damage this one or damage the circuit. Let's check input current of this circuit. Now if you want to measure the current of this unknown circuit, we don't know what is the input current. For safety purpose, first we will use 10 ampere socket, the highest range. And we will select that specific range, 10 ampere. This is milliampere, this is ampere. Ampere for this, milliampere for this socket. 10 ampere DC. First we will connect power to this circuit. Now the circuit is on. Now we can measure current in any one line, entering current from here or here, either in positive line or negative line. When we measure current, basically inside multimeter there is a shunt resistance here, low value resistance. How much current will flow, that will cause to drop some voltage across this shunt resistance, and that voltage will be measured here by its processor, and that will be displayed in form of amperes. Basically that are some voltage here that are being dropped across this shunt resistance. I will open this circuit from positive line, and we will connect positive line of the battery to this input socket. This is entrance and this is exit. So we will connect this exit point to this terminal. Now it is measuring 171 milliampere. Now the second step, I removed the cable, I removed the test lead, I will shift to milliamperes. Now it is auto range. I will switch to manual range. First range is 60 milliampere from 0 to 60. The next is 600 milliampere maximum. 60, 600. Now I will use DC milliampere, and now I will connect here. It is showing 170 milliampere. If you connect directly to this point and circuit is drawing more current, that time at 400 milliampere the fuse will damage. When we have done this measurement, we are finished. Always swap the leads. If this video is informative, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.